Hi, potentiostat is somewhat like that of thermostat. How? A thermostat keeps constant temperature, while a potentiostat keeps constant potential. So there is similarity between two for keeping something constant, that is, temperature and potential. A potentiostat is an analytical instrument. It is a very versatile instrument. We can study lot of parameters and lot of chemical reactions. The soul of a potentiostat is the electrode setup. Usually a potentiostat consists of three electrodes, that is, working electrode or WE, reference electrode or RE, and counter electrode or SE. Potentiostat setup. The working counter and reference electrodes are connected to the cell cable of electrochemical cell on one end, while on the other hand it is connected to the potentiostat's cable. In this diagram of potentiostat, A represents the part of electrochemical cell where cables are attached, and B indicates the point where cables are inserted into the circuit of a potentiostat. Let us dive into electrochemical's electrode system. The working electrode or indicator electrode. Working electrode is the electrode where the electrochemical reaction of interest takes place, and it is made of matter of interest. So we can say that a working electrode is usually made of analyte or the sample material. Examples of working electrode: platinum, gold, and glassy carbon. Here is glassy carbon, which very efficiently works as a working electrode. The reference electrode. The reference electrode is a stable with a non-potential. So we can say a reference electrode has two prominent characteristics. It has non-potential, and reference electrode is used to measure the potential of working electrode. In general, silver and silver chloride and saturated calomel electrodes are used as a reference electrodes. A is a diagram for the silver and silver chloride electrode, while B shows to the saturated calomel electrode. The counter electrode or auxiliary electrode. Counter electrode is used to complete the electrochemical circuit and provides the current needed to drive the electrochemical reaction. It is usually consists of conductive and inert material. The counter electrode is very vital for proper functioning of a potentiostat because it regulates the potential passing through working and a reference electrode. Examples: platinum and graphite, which does not participate in the electrochemical reaction. So these are very inert and very conductive material, so counter electrode are made up of material which are highly stable and highly conductive. Here is a silver and silver chloride electrode which can act as a counter electrode. Other components of a potentiostat. Here is a general diagram for a potentiostat. And here, over here, the first part of the control circuit, that is signal generator, generates the signal and it provides it to the counter electrode, and through this it passes towards the working electrode, and from downward here from the ground point the current passes from the resistance and it also passes towards the working electrode. The input from working electrode and counter electrode passes to the reference electrode, and it again reaches towards the electrometer or differential amplifier, and from here of feedback of voltage again goes to the control electrode. And at the bottom we can see an other input that is going toward the current follower. Now we explain these components in a little bit detail. Signal generator. The signal generator in a potentiostat generates the voltage or current wave that is applied to the electrochemical cell. So signal generator generate a specific type of waveform. The waveform may be of a different type that depends upon the application of the potentiostat. This waveform may be a sine wave or a square wave. The waveform is generated by a digital to analog converter. That is, it is produced in digital form and then it is converted into analog form. The signal generator applies a constant voltage to the electrochemical cell. Here, the function of signal generator is to provide potential, a constant potential, to the electrochemical cell. The control circuit in a potentiostat. It consists of voltage feedback amplifier, a control amplifier, and a power amplifier. So, a control circuit consists of three amplifiers, a voltage feedback amplifier, a control amplifier, and a power amplifier. The voltage feedback amplifier measures the voltage between the working electrode and the reference electrode and feeds this signal to the control amplifier. Voltage feedback amplifier has a major work, that is, to measure the voltage between the working electrode and the reference electrode. The control amplifier compares the measured voltage to the desired voltage and then sends a signal to the power amplifier. The differential amplifier. The differential amplifier amplifies the voltage difference between the working and the reference electrode. And this amplified voltage is proportional to the current flowing through the working electrode. The amplified current signal is then fed to the control circuit of the potentiostat. This feedback loop permits the potentiostat to control the potential of the working electrode. It can also determine voltage drop across a shunt resistor. The shunt resistor is linked with the working electrode and counter electrode. And in that diagram, we have seen the resistor being connected between the working electrode and counter electrode. So the main function of the main function of the differential amplifier is to measure the voltage difference between the working and the reference electrode. The electrometer circuit. The electrometer circuit measures the difference of voltage between the working and reference electrode. This voltage difference is the feedback signal that potentiostat uses to control the voltage applied to the working electrode. So, under the order of the electrometer circuit, the working electrode controls its potential. It provides a key impetus to working electrode. The electrometer circuit provides feedback to potentiostat so that it can maintain a constant voltage at the working electrode. The current follower. It measures the current flowing through the electrochemical cell without affecting the potential of the working electrode. The current follower works using an operational amplifier or op amplifier. Amplifies the current which is passing through the electrochemical cell. When a current flows through the working electrode, it also flows through the feedback resistor. The output voltage of the current follower is proportional to the current flowing through the working electrode. So, higher the current passing through the current follower, higher voltage will be there on the working electrode. Working modes. A potentiostat can work in different modes. Two major modes, that is the potentiostatic mode and the galvanostatic mode. In potentiostatic mode, a constant potential is applied between the working and reference electrode and resulting current is measured. However, in a galvanostatic mode, a constant voltage is applied between reference and counter electrode and resulting voltage is measured. So, in potentiostatic mode, potential is measured, and in a galvanostatic mode, current is measured. Measurement and data acquisition. Potentiostat can provide results in the form of current versus time, or potential or voltage versus time, or there may be different results or parameter for different types of analysis or studies. Here is a typical graph, that is between voltage and current.